TMS Web Core now offers components to integrate MySQL and Postgres databases into your Electron applications. You might associate not the name with Postgres, but you might have seen its elephant logo. Furthermore, MySQL support also includes support for MariaDB, the open source offspring of MySQL. First of all, let me clarify what Electron applications are. Electron applications are web client applications that are deployed as desktop applications. So for you, this means you develop a web client application with TMS Web Core, and the Delphi IDE generates either a Windows executable, a Linux executable, or a macOS executable. For the end user, these applications seem like normal applications on their desktop system. And this is where you might question yourself, hold on a second, web applications cannot access databases like desktop applications. When you are used to developing desktop applications, you can directly communicate and connect to your database server, like seen in this illustration. Your client application connects to the database server, and there's no further layer that you need to consider. With web applications, this is a little bit more complicated, because the web application that TMS Web Core generates runs in the web browser, and the web browser cannot directly communicate with your database server that is inside of your company. You need an additional layer. Most of the time, this is a REST web service. The web application therefore communicates with REST API, and this REST API is inside of your network and communicates with your database. So this is exactly the key. Even though you develop a web application, because with the Electron framework you deploy to your desktop system, you now have the option to also connect to your database servers like on a normal desktop application. There's no longer the need to have a REST web service in between. You can directly connect to your MySQL, MariaDB, and Postgres databases. TMS Web Core is bundled with a great demo. However, you need to prepare a little bit in order to run the demo. Of course, you either need a MySQL, MariaDB, or Postgres server, and you need to create the demo database and its tables. All the information you need is given in the documentation of TMS Web Core. You also will need to make changes to the source code of the demo, which I'll show right now. You'll find the demonstration in the demo folder of TMS Web Core in the Electron directory, and the name is, for example, either MySQL or Postgres, depending on which database server you want to use. I select the MySQL database and the to-do list example. There is also a second example that shows you how to store binary large objects in a database. I'm just going to show the to-do list example at this point. Here we see the main form of the application. You can specify username and password and a login button to log into your database server. In order to connect to the database, you have a connection component, in this case, the T-Electron MySQL connection component, and you also have a dataset component, which is derived of T-dataset. So in order to hook your user interface to your dataset, you can use the web data source component, which is just the same as a T data source component that you're used to from the VCL. And then you have in TMS Web Core visual controls that you can tie directly to your data source. For example, the web DB grid, you can set the data source property to web data source, and the same holds true for the date time picker, for the combo box, and for the memo field. And just like in the VCL, the data source will be tied to the data set. This is all done in code, and this is exactly where you need to make the modifications in order to run the demonstration. You need to set the host name in the host property of the connection, and you need to set your database name that you picked when you created your database. Also, the table name can be specified. You also see that when the form is shown, that the data set of the data source is set to the Electron MySQL client data set in code. These are the settings from my MariaDB database server. Note that I also changed the port to 3307, which is the standard port for MariaDB. MySQL uses 3306. After verifying that the build configuration is set correctly to debug or Win32 or Win64 because I am on a Windows system, I can run the demonstration. The first time you run this, this does not suffice. You also will have to install the libraries into your Electron framework in order to access MySQL and Postgres. That is done by installing the necessary packages into your application. You will have to do this once for every application that you create. The steps necessary to add the packages to your application are given in the documentation. You can clearly see that this is the debug build because we have the menu, the developer menu, that is hidden as soon as you deploy to a real target. My username is sysdba, and as password I use master key in homage to Interbase. I click login, and here's the data from my database in a grid, and I can add a new task, update the date. For example, I can set it to Sunday the 30th. The source code is nothing surprising. You create all the database fields and the indices using dataset methods that you're used to since Delphi 1. And then you can also, on a certain button click, for example, if you want to insert a record, you call the insert method of the dataset. If you want to delete a record, you call the delete method of the dataset. Furthermore, you can cancel and you can post. But of course, this is implicit if you use the DB Navigator, which is also supported in TMS Web Core. In summary, if you've been building database applications with Delphi for a long time, you'll feel right at home with the new support for MySQL and Postgres databases for Electron applications in TMS Web Core.